Hello and welcome to the Paint, Build, Create event, a science, technology, engineering, art, and math themed event for all ages brought to you by the Arlington County Department of Parks and Recreation. My name is Chloe, and today we're going to be making stalactites. Stalactites are naturally found in caves and caverns, and they're created when calcium salts drip from the roof of a cave. They can take thousands, if not millions, of years to be as big as these ones in these pictures. But for our science experiment today, it's only going to take a few days. All you're going to need are a few simple supplies from your house you probably already have, including baking soda, a string, two glasses, and some warm water. The setup is super easy. What you're going to want to do is pour the warm water into both of your glasses. Space them out between 6 to 8 inches apart and pour as much baking soda as you'd like into the glasses until it stops dissolving, like so. Next, you want to pin your string so that each end is in each cup, touching the water. You can even see in this picture, I still have some baking soda sitting at the bottom of the cup. That's just the right amount for my stalactite. You may even need to secure your string with a paper clip or a knot. And all you do after is just wait. There are many different types of environments a stalactite can grow in, ranging from humidity, salt levels, temperature, and darkness. And my friends have agreed to help me explain how those all can come together. So my friends and I have decided to make it a competition on who can grow the best, biggest, and most shiny crystal stalactite there is, just to prove how they can grow in different environments at different times. And in the spirit of competition, we each came up with a name, a backstory, and an athlete bio on each of our stalactites. Let's check them out. Our first stalactite athlete is Justine. Justine is sponsored by Arm & Hammer, and that's where her baking soda came from. She's growing out of some blue ceramic jars, and her yarn is a nice used hemp yarn. Only the finest tap water was used for Justine, and she is sitting in a nice big dark room, her favorite place. And her secret move is being a late bloomer. Let's see how well Justine grows over the next few days. Up next, we have Sally the stalactite. Sally prepared herself for this race by using the freshest box of Arm & Hammer baking soda, an old shoestring, the classic tap water from the kitchen, and two beautiful glass jars. She prefers to grow in straight sunlight. Her favorite motto is that there's no place like home, and her favorite pastime is people watching. We've got high hopes for Sally. Up next, we have Chris the Crystal, who sent a very cryptic message about her training regimen.
I want to introduce to you the crystals of all crystals. Chris the Crystal, the powder used to form this crystal, was taken from Krypton Crystal Planet. And if you've ever seen Superman, you know this will be the biggest and baddest crystal of all time. Superman told me, make sure you use boiling water to dissolve the powder for best results. Oh, and the best crystals form on super absorbent and porous material. So we're going to use this cotton fiber that's braided together, and we'll make sure we put it in a dark space, just like in a cave.
Okay, everybody, we're all finished up. She's in her natural habitat, ready to grow. I have to tell you, if you see Gus, he's always after my secrets of how to make the biggest crystal. So make sure you keep it between us.
And last but not least, we have the elusive Gus Gus. And according to Crystal, we better watch out for this one. Gus Gus prepared for this competition by fueling his body with baking soda from a Costco in Boulder, Colorado from many years ago. He chose some repurposed homemade jam jars as his home and carefully selected his yarn from the advice of a very talented knitter. Only the best tap water for Gus Gus, and only the best location of a kitchen view surrounded by plants for extra oxygen. Well, athletes, let's get this competition started. Ready, set, grow!
You may be wondering why Sally was the winner, and each of us created our own hypothesis around that, thinking that Sally had the most sunlight, she had clear glasses, and she had the most amount of baking soda put into the glasses. Another thing to think about is that her water level always was high enough for the string to touch the water. So when you try to do this at home, give it a shot with all the different features we've gone over today and let us know how it went.
We would like to thank our four Stalactite athletes for participating in this competition, Justine, Chris, Gus Gus, and Sally. Thank you for joining us at the virtual Paint, Build, Create special event. Check out other videos like this series at the link below.